Hi guys, welcome to my channel, and today I'm going to show you how we can handle calendar in Cypress. So this is agenda for today video. So let me open my demo website where I'm going to show you. So this is my demo website PHP Travels, and in this website what we can do, we just search hotel cities and we can click on check-in and the calendar will open, right? So this is my test case for today. And let me open Visual Studio and we'll create a file. So my file name is calendar.spec.js, and we'll give describe test Cypress. Function would be, now I will create a description of test calendar and give a function name, and now I will start. So what I do, first I have to launch the website. So I have use visit method for it, and let me just copy the URL. So I have copied the URL. Now what I have to do, my test case is just go and click first in check-in. So I have to create the XPath of it. So let me identify the XPath. So I would identify check-in ID and will create a XPath for this web element, and I have created the XPath. So what I do, I just go and copy this XPath and write cy.xpath and just dot click. So I have completed till now. Now what I have to do, I have to do go, and when I click on this, then so I have to identify the web element of it. So this is the web element. So let me go above and identify all the web elements are present here, right? So let me create the XPath of it. So this would be my XPath @ class. Just go and put div, right? So this is my XPath, and we'll see that. Okay, now I will go and copy. So let me just move ahead and we'll see whether it is XPath is good or not. So this is the XPath. This is a picker, content picker, days by names, days by pick by cell, and let me first take this XPath and we'll see whether it will work or not. So what I'm go, I just go dot cy XPath, and now I will use each method. So I have already used each method. So each method is used for when we have to iterate within web elements. So it will takes three argument. We can pass 1, 2, 3. It's up to us how we are going to use this method. So first method, first argument will be EL. So this is the jQuery syntax which I'm using here. Is a list. So this is my EY. So what I do, I just go and first I will take var name, So this is a date name I will take and identify $EL.tax. So I will get the tax of that element. Now I will get if date name is equal to, so I am going to select 14. Then what I do, I just go and dot cy dot wrap class and put el and dot click. So we will run this method and we'll see whether it will run correctly or not. So what now we will run the test script and see whether the expected output will see or not. So now I have run the test script. Let me run it. So currently it is loading the URL of the application. Once it loaded, it clicked on click button and it selected. So let me see whether it is selected or not. So we can see that it got selected 14, which we have mentioned at here. Now I will change and give 20. Now we will see whether it will select or not. So again, open the application. Currently it is loading the application URL. And if I close this pop-up, you can see 20 have been selected. So this way we can pass the date and we can handle the calendar. So thank you for watching this video. Take care. Bye.